गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आवर सब्जेक्ट इज वेस्ट वाटर मैनेजमेंट। वी आर इन फोर्थ यूनिट। आवर प्रेजेंट डिस्कशन टॉपिक इज लैंड ट्रीटमेंट, कॉमन एफ्लुएंट ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट्स, एडवांटेजेस एंड सूटेबिलिटी। सो फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ ए लैंड इज कंटामिनेटेड, हाउ कैन वी लैंड ट्रीटमेंटेड एंड बाय यूजिंग बाय common effluent treatment plants, I mean what are the common effluent treatment of plants using in land treatment, what is their advantages and what is the suitability. These all things we are going to discuss in our class. Guys, here common effluent treatment plants. Guys, the concept of common effluent treatment plant CETP has been accepted as a solution for collecting, conveying, treating and disposing of effluents from industrial estates. The effluents include industrial wastewaters and domestic sewage generated in these estates. The CETPs are designed to help small scale and medium scale industries located within the estates to dispose of their effluents, which in many cases are small in volume but have a high pollution potential. These industries cannot afford to treat their wastewaters individually because of space constraints and financial limitations, but they are expected to give at least preliminary treatment in order to ensure that the common collecting sewer remains free flowing. It may be necessary in certain cases to provide pH correction also before discharging the effluents into the collecting sewer, as is the case with any wastewater treatment facility. A CETP is designed on the basis of 4 points, 5 points. Point one, the quality and the flow rate of the wastewater. Second point is standard of quality of treated effluent stipulated by the pollution control authority. Third point, possibility of recycle, reuse or recovery of a treated wastewater. Fourth point is availability of land, labor, power for operating and maintaining the CETP, and willingness of the industries located in the industrial estate to contribute towards the capital and operating expenses of the CETP. A CETP can be changed to a combined effluent treatment plant when it collects domestic sewage from surrounding areas and treats it with industrial waste. The advantages of such a system are as follows. Dilution is offered to the toxic constituents and inorganic dissolved solids in the industrial waste. Continuous seeding of microorganisms is possible when the mixture is subjected to biological treatment. Better control over treatment plant is possible than if a sewage is treated in a separate plant. Sewage provides nitrogen and phosphorus as nutrients to the microorganisms which treat industrial waste deficient in these elements. This reduces running cost of adding chemicals to some extent. CETPs are broadly grouped under two headings. Homogeneous, in which industries producing similar goods are located in one area, for instance, tanneries or engineering goods or pulp and paper etc. And a heterogeneous, in which industries producing widely divergent goods are placed together, such as chemical, dairy, food and fruit processing, tanneries, pulp and paper, pharmaceutical, etc. Designing a treatment plant for the first group is easier than for the second group, as the characteristics of raw waste produced in the former tend to show lesser variations than the latter. Advantages of providing a CETP are the following. Small and medium scale industries are relieved of the problem of treating their effluents. Wastewater treatment is assured, thereby helping pollution control. The pollution controlling authorities have to monitor only one outlet to check the performance of the CETP. And participating industries have a commitment to generate only wastewater acceptable for treatment in the CETP. Industries can concentrate on finding ways and means of reducing pollution at sources, reduce water and power consumption to the extent possible. Many factors need careful consideration in establishing a CETP. Ownership. Ownership can be either in private sector or public sector or joint private and public sectors. Private sector ownership. Here guys, in this individual industries, form a cooperative company and become its shareholders. Advantages of this form are the expression of commitment to pollution control by the industries, short-term problems of manpower and equipment can be overcome by resources available in member industries. This form of ownership is generally accepted, although there can be conflict among member industries regarding wastewater quality and quantity. All participating industries pay a fair share in the cost of treatment depending on quality and quantity of wastewater. Failure to pay can result in imposing penalty on the defaulting industry by way of non-acceptance of its effluent into the CETP. Public sector ownership. The State Industrial Development Corporations, SIDC, provide all infrastructural facilities including CETPs. But these being government organizations, conflict of interest in regard to compliance and strict enforcement by the state pollution control boards may be difficult. Joint private and public sector ownership. A company is formed by the SIDC and the Industries Association. This arrangement improves availability of funds, but it can result in delays in defining responsibilities. Technical aspects. Technical aspects include basic information. Information about individual units, their raw materials, products, treatment, if any is being given, quality and quantity of wastewater generated. Scope for reducing water consumption and waste minimization. Collection and convenience. Wastewater is conveyed either by underground drainage system or by tankers, hand carts, etc. if the volume involved is small. Free treatment. Rotational free treatment to be given by individual units irrespective of the mode of convenience of the wastewater. Planning. Master plan and phase-wise approach if uncertainty exists about quantity, quality, and treatability. Disposal. Handling treatment and disposal of sludge generated either during free treatment or treatment in the CETP. Financial aspects. I'm sorry guys, due to system or internet, some malfunctions working in our system, but okay, now it's guys, here financial aspects, it is a common observation that the unit cost of treatment becomes very high if the wastewater flow is small. Similarly, a group of heterogeneous industries will produce an effluent with a varying quality, hence it becomes costlier to treat than if the group consists of homogeneous industries. Topographic conditions also play an important part in arriving at the cost of treatment, as well as the method of collecting and conveying wastewater from member industries. After a detailed study of 40 CETPs, Kantawala made the following recommendation: a detailed techno-economic study of convenience of wastewaters is necessary, as it accounts for a large part of capital cost. Optimization of free treatment by individual industries is essential. Phase-wise development of a CETP should be seriously considered, but the quality of the treated effluent must meet the standards laid down by the pollution control authorities. Upgradation of the CETP should also be kept in mind in view of the possibility of increased flows, stronger waste, stricter standards of treated effluent. In plant pollution control, should be encouraged by the central and state pollution control boards and Ministry of Environment and Forests. Common effluent treatment plants should be converted into combined effluent treatment plants with obvious advantages, as mentioned earlier. The status of CETPs studied is presented in table here. Guys, here status of CETPs up to April. So in Andhra Pradesh, commissioned, completed, in progress, and state-wise total. In Andhra Pradesh, 3 commissioned, completed 0, in progress 0, state-wise total 3. In Gujarat, commissioned 5, completed 0, in progress 0, state-wise total 5. In Haryana, commissioned 1, completed 0, in progress 0, and state-wise total 1. In Karnataka, commissioned 2, completed 1, in progress 0, and state-wise total 3. In Madhya Pradesh, commissioned 1, completed 0, in progress 2, and state-wise total 3. Maharashtra, commissioned 3, completed 0, in progress 3, step-wise, state-wise total 6, Maharashtra. In Rajasthan, commissioned 2, completed 0, in progress 0, and state-wise total 2. Tamil Nadu, 9 commissioned, completed 8, in progress 13, state-wise total 30. Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh, okay, Tamil Nadu is good. And the Uttar Pradesh commissioner two completed zero, Infogrames zero, statewide total two. Delhi commissioner zero, completed zero, Infogrames 15, statewide total 15. So in Delhi, total 28 commissioner, 9 completed, Infogrames 33, and the statewide total 70. Deshpande and Sen have suggested, besides the usual factors to be considered in the design of a CETP, the classification of waste as those amenable to biological treatment, those which can biologically treated after acclimatization, those which need free treatment, and those which contain non-biodegradable and toxic pollutants. They also suggest the three following approaches for the process design of CETV. Modular approach, which takes into account changes in the volume of wastewater as the industrial estate develops. Upgradably approach, where in the present form of treatment would need upgradation on account of increased flows, stronger waste treatment effluent standards, and increased possibility of recovery of valuable material from the wastewater. Service center approach, which should provide a workshop, garage, laboratory, instrumentation facility, and a conference hall. Guys, the CETP at Sarigam under Gujarat Industrial Development Corporation, GIDC, was studied by these authorities. It serves four zones divided according to activities. For example, zone one, mechanical and water intensive zone, Zone two, so from one, mechanical and water intensive. Zone two, chemical. Zone three, housing and plastics. And zone four, mechanical. Total flow, 14,200 meters cubes per day. Treated effluent was proposed to be reused in the estate, used for horticulture, or given to surrounding farmland during dry season. Prabhu presented a case study of a CETP whose development was done in phases. In phase one, an equalization cum neutralization, the shortcut is ECN, tank and aerated lagoon was provided. In phase two, chemical coagulation, settling, and sludge handling was introduced between ECN tank and aerated lagoon. In phase three, an additional intermediate clarifier, second stage aeration tank, and secondary clarifier were added. Sewage from nearby residential colony was added at this stage to the industrial waste to dilute high total dissolved solids CDS in the wastewater and to seed the mixture with microorganisms. In phase four, dissolved air flotation DAF was added downstream of clarifloculator. In addition, sludge thickening and centrifugation were provided. The treated effluent was discharged to the municipal sewer. A heterogeneous group of industries numbering 348 including units are doing rolling and pickling, textile processing, planting and anodizing, soap making, rubber, plastic goods, and candle making was established at Wazirpur Industrial Area by Delhi Development Authority. The need for a CETP was felt because the effluents damaged the sewerage system and air pollution due to the industries had an adverse effect on the health of the workers. Characteristics of the combined wastewater were as shown here. here guys, the combined wastewater quality, this is the parameter, this is the concentration. Guys, all values except pH are in milligram per liter. In pH, 3.39 to 6.85. Turbidity or N2U 65 to 600 milligram per liter. Total suspended solids is nothing but a TDS 404 to 1573 milligram per liter. BOD, biological oxygen demand 72 to 112 milligram per liter. And the COD, common oxygen demand 248 to 900 milligram per liter. Nickel 6.02 to 33.66 milligram per liter. Total chromium 6.5 to 27.33 milligram per liter. Iron 117.90 to 188.63 milligram per liter. Cadmium 0.02 to 0.056 milligram per liter. Zinc 1.925 to 2.5 milligram per liter. Copper 1.2 to 2.45 milligram per liter. Cyanide 0.6 to 0.9 milligram per liter. Guys, the wastewater was acidic in nature and contained heavy metals. The treatment proposed was therefore equalization, neutralization with lime and settling in a chlorifloculator. The settled sludge would be stored in a lagoon while the clarified effluent would be discharged into municipal sewer. Construction, operation, and maintenance of the CETP would be the responsibility of Municipal Corporation of Delhi, while the cost of operation and maintenance would be met by the industries. Another heterogeneous group of industries in a chemical complex was described by Rajagopalan and et al. And others. The industrial complex consisted of a fertilizer unit, a calcium carbide CaC2 unit, caustic soda plant, a PVC unit, a cement plant, thermal power station, a water treatment plant, and a demineralization plant. Each of these units had its own wastewater treatment plant. The authors have described them briefly and I have suggested steps to improve their performance. Rao and Venkaya and Rambabu have described the problems of managing a heterogeneous CETP with bulk drug manufacture as the main contributor of wastewater 65%, followed by dye intermediate manufacture 20% and the rest 15%. Miscellaneous products. The CETP received sludge flows of wastewater mainly because of batch production by the drug manufacturers. There were wide variations in pH 1.02 10.0, TDS 22-350 milligram per liter, of which 70% were inorganic. And chemical oxygen demand 3 to 95 milligram per liter. The POD versus COD ratio varied from 0.1 to 0.8. It was therefore necessary to segregate high TDS effluents and give them free treatment. Inorganic TDS in biological treatment could not be tolerated beyond 2.5%. Anaerobic treatment was totally unsuccessful. Even aerobic treatment was possible only after segregation high TDS streams, since bulk drug making was the main contributor. A screening test to establish a toxic and inhibitory nature of a waste stream was devised based on the oxygen uptake rate. It was interesting to see that gentamicin, a bulk drug, increased oxygen uptake rate. while paracetamol decreased it. This was used as a basis for the screening test. It was also proposed to add about 300 meters cube per a day of domestic sewage from surrounding areas to the total effluent in order to dilute the total dissolved solids and provide continuous seeding of microorganisms. The CETP had a treatment plan consisting of equalization cum neutralization, plash mixing, clarifloculation, aerated lagoon, and intermediate clarifier and activated sludge process. The treated effluent was discharged into a sewer. The authors suggested improvements to the existing plant, example, increasing the holding capacity of the ECN tank to 5 days and converting aerated lagoon to activated sludge process. The treated effluent could then be connected to the sewerage system. The sludge generated would be incinerated using auxiliary fuel. And Rajamani and others have described a homogeneous CETP for a cluster of 14 tenaries in Bangalore. It consists of a 150 meter cube holding tank, grid chamber, an equalization tank of 100 meters cube capacity with floating aerators for mixing lime, primary clarifier, a acid dosing, activated sludge process with nutrient supplementation, floating aerators for aeration and mixing, and sludge drying beds. Daily for treated was 1000 meters cube. The treated effluent was discharged into Bangalore Water Supply and Sewerage Board's BWSSB drainage system, carrying a sewage flow of more than 20,000 meters cube per day. In order to minimize the problem of sludge disposal, it was proposed to provide chromium recovery and reuse the plant in the tanneries, practicing chrome tanning. So guys, this is the topic we discussed today. So land treatment and common effluent treatment plants, advantages and the shortability. So these are the our present topic. So guys, I want to remind what we discussed here, the main points. So in common effluent treatment plants, you have to recognize the site headings means. Site heading means the ownership is the one of the site heading, and public sector ownership and joint provide and public sector ownership, technical aspects, basic information, collection and convenience, and free treatment, planning and disposal, and financial aspects. And modular approach, upgradability approach, and service center approach. The stable also very important in combined wastewater quality, what parameters and has the what concentrations. It is also most important, guys. But here, always you remember, only pH is not the only pH. pH has no units, but remaining all things we have to calculate in only milligram per liters only. So I think guys, so all of you understood this class. Thank you for all of you for your patience.